Welcome back, everybody. This your boy Turtle with So You Think You Know Sports. And today on Fired Up, we got none other than that man,
Jeezy Miyake. Y'all know what it is.
And I know what y'all thinking. I know. And you right. We did take a little hiatus, man. The Saints lost, man. That was tough.
Wasn't my decision.
He was ready to record, man, but I just couldn't do it, man. I just couldn't bring myself to record, man. That was tough. We was right there, G.
Man, it's history right there, man.
We was right there, man.
It's gonna go down in history.
Yeah, when we older, bro, we gonna think about that, man. I mean, that's gonna be. We gonna come up with a name for that one day, but yeah, that's what the issue was, man. But on to the next, man. We apologize to the fans. There's our loyal fans that do like to tune in to us and check out all our show,
but
man.
But y'all know we was coming back, though.
We coming back, and we coming back harder. And but like I say, let's jump over to this free agency frenzy, man. Because it's a fucking frenzy right now, man. It's going crazy. And
Domino's falling.
Domino's falling like a mug, G. And the first one to fall, though, was none other than that man, mama that man, Drew Brees. You know, that's our guy. Boy, he was a free agent, and we signed him to a 2-year deal. It's basically a 1-year deal, G. It's like a LeBron deal now. He gonna be on that 1-year deal thing. Well, see what it is, it's smart for both of them, you know?
Yeah.
You can walk away at any point, and they can also turn their back on them at any point, so to speak. You know, I don't see happening. And while I got this time, let me go ahead and say, I want to send out my condolences to the Benson family. Saints fans. We've been Saints fans.
Man, that was so a good
through,
man.
He was one of the good ones.
He opened the dome up to the Katrina victims.
He was one of the good ones. Yeah.
With Mercedes Benz talking about
that. Mercedes Benz, they immediately
not everybody do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Look at what Joel Osteen did or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
He
took him a couple days till the media got involved. But we talking about free agency frenzy today. We don't want to get into the politicking just yet. We're gonna say that for the season. I might say that for the end of this segment, for that matter.
Trump's gonna get us back talking about
it. He always do, right? But like I say, man, I got a couple notes right here, and that boy Minnesota, man. Minnesota done X'd out all the quarterbacks, man. All the quarterbacks they was on their roster, G. They gone.
I don't get it. I don't see
all of them gone. Keenum gone. Bradford gone, and Bridgewater, for God's sakes, gone. Wow. And Alex Smith ends up in Washington. Kirk Cousins takes the position in Kirk Cousins ends up going, broke the bank for him in Minnesota. Got rid of all their quarterbacks to go ahead and get Kirk Cousins. And to me, Kirk Cousins is good, but I mean, 86 mil guaranteed.
That boy, that.
Guaranteed,
man,
G.
Your agent, bro.
They try to back the truck off of Drew,
man.
G. They try to give Drew 60 mil on the slip. Fuck y'all. Try to give Drew 60 mil on the slip.
Though, man.
I mean, why wouldn't you? You got to offer it to him. You trying to go for the bowl, the ship, right? But I jumped the gun.
What's the name? Alex
Smith now took his spot in Washington. Alex Smith then took his spot in Washington, and Alex Smith, they moving on, Kansas City moving on to Pat Mahomes there.
Washington, they crumbled.
Washington,
they messed that whole situation up.
Oh, man, you never let a quarterback get away. Kirk Cousins is probably not the best guy ever, but, I mean, you never let somebody get away when you have it, you know what I mean?
Bro.
And for them to do two franchise tags and to let them get away, I just don't understand that. I really don't understand that, man.
Yeah, I don't get it.
I don't get that one, G.
I don't understand, you know, broke the bank
they
on
broke the
Alex,
bank, man.
Alex Smith, too.
Yeah, they gave him, I don't remember the details on his, I ain't gonna lie, man. But for the Minnesota quarterbacks that did leave, you got Case went to Broncos, Bradford went to the Cards, and Teddy Bridgewater went to the Jets. I mean, so in retrospect, they all left from being behind each other over there fighting, jockeying for position, so to speak, and now they all gonna get a chance to shine in their own rights. And
so who you think won the deal then out of all three of
them?
Bradford,
I'm gonna tell you right now. I don't like Bradford. I don't know how this dude keep getting paid. I'm gonna tell you that much right now.
Man,
I don't know how this dude keep getting paid, man.
He another Kirk Cousins.
But
Kirk Cousins
out of all of them,
took it all to a whole other level.
Out of all the quarterbacks that went to a new team, G, honestly, the one that I hadn't mentioned yet, I feel like it's gonna be the beneficiary. It's gonna be the best one, man. And that's Tyrod Taylor. And I really feel like Tyrod can the Browns, they got a, they ceiling can only go up. You know what I mean? Their ceiling can only go up. You know, so and, I mean, their ceiling can only go up, bro. So they got Hyde. We're gonna jump over to the running backs right quick. They got Hyde. The Browns got Hyde. So they added the Hyde is the running back, Carlos Hyde, the running back from 49ers.
Yeah.
They snatched him up. So to me, I feel like they put some shit together. You know, they got Landry over there too now. They put some shit together.
Try to get Saquon Barkley. If they do.
And
they'll be dumb if LeGarrette they don't get
Blunt, LeGarrette Blunt went to the Lions. Man, Blunt always, Blunt is a force, man. I mean, he's been a force ever since he punched that boy in Oregon, man.
Blunt force trauma.
Blunt, hey, look, you called it, and he was balling his ass off for them too, man. Like you said,
Eagles,
bro.
Yeah.
He definitely did, man. Jared McKinnon, he left the Vikings as well. So the Vikings is going to be a different team, man. Jared McKinnon went to the 49ers. So he replacing Carlos Hyde over there at the 49ers. So
and the Vikings going to be a different team. Because
the Vikings going to be a different team.
Aaron Rodgers is going to be back. I don't know what's the this love affair. They are a good team. Do not get me wrong. They're a damn good team. But they beat us, bro, because they was well rested.
Yeah.
We came in. Look how they just crumbled, bro.
Well, they,
what type of
them.
Team would have went to the NFC Championship after luckily getting
it? I mean, we beat them.
Come on,
opinion,
bro.
Man, we beat
them. Man, we won. That's the only time
Jonathan
you ever say
Stewart
you won the
also,
game and lost it.
Jonathan Stewart departed from our foe, Carolina. He going to the Giants, so he out of the division.
Know
that's
about, I'm like, you know, I know about.
Well, I know about Johnny, just trust me. And I mean, he probably on the tail end of his career, but he could definitely offer the Giants something with Eli Manning already being in place and them snatching up Nate Solder.
What you think they gonna do in the draft though?
I think they going quarterback, man, and I think rightfully they should. I mean, I think they now. If Barkley's there, I'm going Barkley, you know. But if the quarterback's there and Barkley's not, then I got to go quarterback. You know, I just got to.
Yeah.
You know, I just got to, though.
Which quarterback you like the most
out of the quarterbacks coming in there, man? To me, bro, I'm going to be honest with you, man. I think Chosen Rosen is the better quarterback coming in right now, man. I feel like
Baker.
Be ready, man.
Baker Mayfield.
You've been on Baker, though. You've been Baker fan, though. You've been a Baker fan.
How he blowing their mind back, too.
But let's throw out a couple wide receivers, though, man. Let's get on these wide receivers. And we're going to start with the first wide receiver, who's not a wide receiver, but he a wide receiver. And that's Jimmy Graham, man, going to Green Bay. That's a good move, man. I ain't gonna lie, man. Jimmy Graham going to Green Bay for them. That's a good move for him and for them because Jimmy Graham had 8 touchdowns last year. Jordy Nelson had 6 touchdowns last year. Jordy Nelson's departure, that means what? He about to force it into Jimmy Graham now, man.
Really, that's what you got to think about. Aaron Rodgers wasn't even there.
Yeah.
So Jordy Nelson, y'all, who knows?
Nothing.
He might have became nothing, or it might have just been the quarterback.
I mean, he ended up going to Oakland. Jordy Nelson, they let Jordy Nelson go, so he ended up going to Oakland. So I'm fine with that. But what I'm saying is, Jimmy Graham is going to be the beneficiary of him not being there now. You know what I mean? Aaron Rodgers likes the security blanket, and Jimmy Graham, I promise you, is a wide receiver before he is a tight end. So he definitely going to be able
to. You got you a good player.
What
right
you think
there,
about Jarvis Landry going to the Browns like we had already touched on? What you think about that, though, man? What you making of that, man? With Tyrod Taylor at the helm, too.
Browns, bro, they've been real impressive.
And they still got the number one
look
pick.
Look at how they went, got weapons. This is what you need on offense.
Yeah.
Weapons. Tyrod Taylor, he's not the end all to be all. They gonna put him in a competition with whoever they gonna draft that quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe it's gonna be Baker. And Baker is gonna win that starting job because y'all know how
got,
I feel about Tyrod
Taylor. Allen Robinson went to the Bears. You got Allen Robinson went to the Bears. Sammy Watkins went to the Chiefs. So that's another weapon for them. They got Kareem Hunt was balling last year. Hill, that boy was balling his ass off, been a beast. So that's another weapon for Pat Mahomes, like you're saying. When you put weapons on offense, you giving yourself a better position.
Yeah.
No matter how you slice it, you giving yourself a better position.
That's what you need.
Amendola, he bailed out on Brady and them. He going to the Dolphins, an in division foe. He going to the Dolphins on them.
Tell
man.
Us about the Patriots culture now.
Yeah. Tell us what I mean, look how many players that left these boys, man. Then you got Crabtree going to the Ravens. He left the Raiders and he going to the Ravens. So I feel like Crabtree is one of those players, man. You just really can't put your finger on that guy, man. I ain't gonna lie. I'm not gonna knock him.
I don't think Well, I mean,
for 20-something mil, man, I'm you know, I ain't gonna knock him, man. That's not the break the bank type of money. You know what I mean? That's good for what he can bring for you. Yeah. You know, but I'm saying out of the receivers going to a different team on different change of scenery, who you think gonna have the biggest impact, G?
I'm gonna have to go with Jimmy Graham.
No doubt, man. I'm gonna have to go with Jimmy Graham too, man.
Jimmy,
that's a fact, bro.
The biggest impact on that team.
Then we gonna go to we gonna go to the DBs, man. And Aqib Talib, he went ahead and departed from Denver, and he going to LA, and he gonna team up with Marcus Peters out there in LA. So they just formed a hell of a tandem out there, man. They just formed a hell of a tandem, man.
The chain snatcher.
Yeah, the chain snatcher. Yeah, man.
Speaking of Crabtree.
Yeah, Crabtree. So that's what I'm saying. Crabtree, Aqib Talib, and Marcus Peters. That's some guys, man.
And Marcus Peters, this is 13.
Remember Marcus Peters last year? He tossed that flag. Remember he cut up, bro. Man. That boy ain't got problems, man. Then Kurt Coleman, Saints snatched him up from Carolina. So that's a good addition for the Saints, man. Then we also got P. Rob, too.
Yeah,
we brought P. Rob back, man. Shout out to P. Rob, man.
Nice,
I ain't got a problem
pickup
with that,
right,
man.
There, bro.
We got P. Rob back. P. Rob is going to be a hell of a slot corner, man. He put himself, they said, I read somewhere that they said he became the number three slot corner last year, man. As far as slot corners go, he was number three on the list. So
man, that's
a big pickup,
back
man.
Home. That's
and he
real.
Coming back home. He was our number one pick a couple years ago. I think we picked him like number 29 or something.
That's why Jimmy should have came back home.
Then you got Tremaine Johnson went to the Jets. So he left the Rams and went to the Jets. Then you got the Honey Badger going to the Texans, man.
Oh,
you know,
man,
I got
to
like
hit
that,
it.
Man. I got to like that, man.
Damn.
Honey Badger went to the Texans, man. Honey Badger signed a deal with the Texans. He actually signed a prove it year. He signed a prove it deal, man. Signed
one
a 1-year deal. $7 million. So he actually took less money than the Cards had offered him. So he really banking on himself. So that really means in the event that he balls out,
be coming
you know,
back.
Oh yeah, man, they're gonna be a good defense. And you got Deshaun Watson coming back.
That's our team,
you know,
on the AFC side.
Oh yeah, that's our team on the AFC side. They know that. I always shout out them. Then you got Richard Sherman. Bitter like a motherfucker,
man,
stayed
boy,
in rival
man.
And went to the 49ers. Man, he bitter like a bitch, man.
Man,
he built like a bitch,
information,
man. Waiting to exhale,
about,
man.
Started talking about how Pete Carroll, he is more better for college.
He say it's like
on,
built
bro.
For a college team, a 4-year
Why
program.
Why would you do that, though, bro?
But
all
he does
is making
though.
Himself.
He said it.
No,
what he
making
said
himself
makes
look
sense,
bad,
though,
too.
Man. I don't care, bro.
He making himself look bad.
I fuck
right
with Richard Sherman, man.
I fuck with him, too, but what he did right there, that's something you don't do. You leave that in-house.
I understand what you're saying.
Especially from a great team like that.
Then you got, we jump over to the linebackers, man. You got the Saints snatched up a hell of a up-and-coming guy.
All the Jets
name,
seemed like they was burning.
They bust out of there, man. The Jets got out of there.
Quick.
But we snatched him up from the Jets, man, and he pretty good, man. So that's somebody to be reckoned with. Then you got Haloi Ngata left. He went to the Eagles. The Eagles added a hell of a piece. The Vikings snatched up Big Richardson.
And Sue, we trying to get that boy Sue, man.
Then Star Luke Tutule, yeah, we trying to get Sue, man. Star Tutule, he left Carolina, so that's good for us.
But you just said they spotted him
at the airport, so he out of there. He
living,
building.
Bro.
He out the building.
That's
he chasing that dollar,
good.
Man. He chasing that dollar,
good.
Man. But yeah, man, the free agency been crazy, man. With all of those players going to new teams, man. All of those players going to new teams. So who you think is the biggest player going to a new team, G? Who you think will have the biggest impact?
The biggest impact, I believe, Jimmy. But the biggest player is going to be that Kirk Cousins one. Kirk Cousins.
Kirk Cousins is the biggest name that went to another team. But I, like you say, as far as impact players, I got to believe that the Honey Badger is going to make a hell of an impact, man. Because remember when they had Ed Reed? They was balling. You know, they had a hell of a secondary when they had Ed Reed. So now they get to unleash the Badger and let him go out there and run his own plays and stuff. So I like what they're doing, man.
I believe he's going to be damn good for Texas.
I like
Texas.
What they're doing, man.
But
that's all we got for y'all today, man. Welcome back. You know, all of that. Like, comment, and subscribe. You know what I'm saying? Got a new little camera for y'all. A couple of angles and stuff. Hope y'all like it. You know, this your boy Turtle with So You Think You Know Sports.
It's Jesus Miyake.
Y'all know what it is. He rushing shit, y'all. All right, man. We gonna kill it, man.
All right.